get the variables in Postman. So for the before that, I'll be going to file, then click on name. Here collection option is there, just click on it. Here a new collection is created. Now I will just rename the collection. So this is my collection, and then inside the collection I am going to create one folder. Then I'll just rename the folder name. Yeah, now the folder is created, and I had given the name of Get API. Let me go to the browser. So this is a browser I am using, Rick RES. So let me go to the Get API. So just list users I am going to take. So here just click on it. So this is a URI I am going to take. So inside that I will be going to create one API request. So here I added the URL name, and then I selected the get request over here. For here params is page equal to 2 and sending, and just sending the get request over here. So this is a response body as a in a JSON format. So let me, here I have got status code is 200 and text is okay, and time then size of the JSON file. So let me, I'll be going to create one more API request. So let me, I'll be going to use single user. Let me go to Postman. I'll be going to create one more API request. Let me rename this one. Single user. So let me, I'll add this URL of over here. So here I'm going to select get. Let me send the request. So here I got a response body as in the JSON format. Yeah, so for here this is common for URL. So here also it is common. So what I will do, I will be going to create a variables. So for the before that, here we have a, like we have variable scopes are for different task in Postman. We have a global variables. So what it does is, global variable allows us to data between the collections, request and test scripts and environments. So global variables are available throughout a workspace. So this is my default workspace is created over my workspaces. It is a default workspace I am using. So if you want to use any other workspace, you can create, you can use the new new options, and it is going to create a new workspace. So for that global variable, we need to use for the global variable. And global variables can create like it is you should be only for example quickly test something or when your project is at very early in the prototyping stage. So this is one using the global variables. Let me here I have a global variable options. Let me here we have a option called as globals, and then you have to add it in the global variables. So here we have a the scope of the variable is global or global variables, and we have a variables initial value and current values. Let me close this one. So this is a global variable parts. Now let me go to the collection variable. So yeah, this is our collection variable. Here if I click on edit option, for once I will click on the dot dot. So here I have a prerequisite test and variables. So this is for the collection level of variables. So here also you can add the variables. Okay, now let me I'll close this one. Yeah, this is a collection level of variables. This will be available throughout the request in a collection and are independent of environments. So here let me go to the environment part. So here I have default environment, no environment. So if you go to the environment, so if you click on the add option over here, so here also you can give the name of the environment and give the variables and initial and current value. So this is for the environment variables. So it will allows us to processing to a different environments. Like for example, we have a local development or local development environment and testing environment, production environment, so and so on. So whenever we are writing the scripts, then we are using the different environments. So we have to go for environment using the environment variable. So here using the collection variables can be more efficient. However, environment allows you to specify the role-based access levels. And we have one more variables called as local variables. So for local variables are temporary and only accessible in your request and scripts, and local variables value are scoped in a single request to collection run and available in the complete of the local variables. And so we have also data variables. So come from the external CSV and JSON files, define the data sets. You can use running collections via Newman or the collection runner. This part I will be going to show you in upcoming video part. So now for the I will show you how to define the variables. Like we have a variety of ways to, depending on whether you need to global or environment or collection level scope. So however, you need to write the script for that according to you use for the different environments and the scope of the variables. Now I'll be going to show you how to set a variable and set as a new variable. So those variables, and let me, I'm going to show you. Let me go to the URL. So I'll be just going to use this one. Let me go to click on this I icon and then go to the globals. And then I'm going to add initial value. So it for current value also we need to add. Then here I'll be going to save this one. And then I'll go to here. Using curly braces, I'm just using the URL. Okay, let me send this request. Yeah, here I'm getting the correct response over here. Just me hover it. So it will show like whatever I'm adding the values over here. Yeah, let me, I'll be going to add. Then I'll be going to save this request. Similarly, I'll be going to add one more request. Let me send this request. So I got the correct response over here. Let me save this. Now I'll be just show you. Going to the here, we have a test tab is there. So just click on it. So let me write the code script for that. Just console.log, I'm just printing the hello world. Just send me the request over here. Sending, I'll clicking on send option. So okay, let me go to the console. So here I got the hello world, whatever I am passing the printing the sentence. So it will be I passed hello world text, so it is showing like hello world. So using the console option. Okay, let me clear this. Now pm dot variables, then get so so here I am creating one variable to store that value. And then I am printing that. Yeah, let me send this request. Whatever I am passing the URL over here, okay, I got the same URL over here. Okay, this for I am getting that URL. Now, Now let me, I'll be going to add some Let me save this. Here for the name I used for the postman values, so it is similarly it is showing like postman. So this is for the for getting the variables. Now let me I'll be similarly we can write the code for so for the test I use for script, so that is what it is showing over here. So like that we need to write the code for using the variables. Now let me I'll show you. So I'm setting the name of that, and then I have created the variable, then set the name and postman value. So let me send this request. Yeah, here I got the script and postman. The name I have given the, then for I got as a postman. So similarly, if I for set variables, if I am going to use test and scripts over here, so let me send this request. So here I got as a scripts. So for to set the variables, so this is a script over here. So so in this video I had shown for how to set and get the variables in the postman collection. For this is a script. So in the upcoming video I'll be going to show you how to write the script for the whatever we are getting the response body. So those scripts I'll be going to show you in the next video. So I'm kindly requesting you to subscribe this channel, and if you have any comments, let me know. So in the next video I'll be going to show you how to write the script for the API request. Thank you.